So the eye dominance test. Well, in this video, we're gonna show you how to test eye dominance so that you can tell if you're left eye dominant or right eye dominant. So let's take a look. Hey everyone, this is Dr. Joe Allen here from Dr. Eye Health. The channel helps with the eyes, vision, and finding the best vision products. So if you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe so you don't miss any of my future videos. Also, at any point throughout the video, you can check out the show notes and links below for further information about everything that I go over. Otherwise, let's talk about eye dominance. So knowing eye dominance can be a really important thing to know. I know for myself, being an eye doctor, I need to know the eye dominance of my patients in order to fit specialty contact lenses for monovision, as well as getting people ready for cataract surgery or even LASIK eye surgery. But for just about everybody else, knowing eye dominance can play a critical role for a lot of different activities. If you're somebody who wants to know eye dominance for shooting, whether you're shooting a rifle or a shotgun, this can be really important, especially if you are cross-eye dominant. Also, if you are somebody who maybe wants to know eye dominance for archery, or if you want to know eye dominance for pool or billiards, this also can play a critical role. Even photographers will shoot better if they know their eye dominance. Now let's go over a couple of different ways where you can find out, are you left eye dominant or right eye dominant? So my favorite way to test eye dominance is using a distant object. So wherever you are, just look in the distance, find something that you can focus on. Here in the clinic, as an example, we're gonna go ahead and use the eyeball in the eye clinic logo. So while you're focusing on that distant object with both eyes open, you're gonna go ahead and make your hands into a big triangle like you're gonna catch a football. You're gonna extend your arms and try to get that triangle to be right over that distant object. Then you're gonna go ahead and make that triangle smaller and smaller over that distant object until you can just barely focus that object right in the middle. While keeping that object focused in the middle of the triangle, you can either choose to close one eye, kind of like here, I can close my right eye, and while closing that eye, if you can still see the object, then the open eye is your dominant eye. If you end up closing your dominant eye during this test, you'll actually see that the object is no longer centered in the middle of the triangle, it's going to be off center. Another variation of the same method that I like a little bit more because it's a little bit fun, and if you're somebody who can't close your eyes individually, then it's gonna work a little bit easier. Still keep that object in the middle of the triangle, but then slowly bring your arms back, keeping your eyes open and threading that object through the triangle. Eventually, you'll end up threading that distant object right up to the eye that you're more eye dominant in. Another way you can test eye dominance is using a plus magnifying lens. And as long as both eyes are actually corrected for distance, your doctor can use these plus lenses to hold it over just one eye at a time while both eyes are open. The eye that's more significantly blurred is the eye that is dominant. So for me, if I cover my right eye here with the plus lens, I can still see out of my left eye really well, so things are still relatively clear. But if I cover and plus and blur out my left eye, then no, things are really blurry and it's more difficult to see. There's one other method, using your thumb, where you basically find that same distant object and try to eclipse it with your thumb. Again, both eyes open. It's kind of the same principle. You either close or cover one eye, and the eye that can still eclipse the object, that's the eye that's dominant. Most people who are right-handed are usually right-eye dominant as well, just like left-handed people are usually left-eye dominant as well. I'm left-eye dominant. And that's kind of strange that I'm left-eye dominant because I'm also right-handed. We call that cross-eye dominance. And for a lot of activities and sports, this can make things difficult. I find archery to be very difficult for me because I can't really focus with my right eye as well as my left eye. However, there has been some arguments that athletes who are cross-eye dominant have an advantage in that they can actually focus on the ball or the target easier with their opposite eye because their whole bodies are usually turned toward the opposite team. As in baseball, you have your body turned toward the pitcher and you're watching the ball come toward you. However, they've done statistical analysis and found that that's not necessarily true. But is it possible to not have a dominant eye? The answer is yes. Some people actually don't have a dominant eye. Both eyes work relatively really well together. However, that's pretty rare and uncommon to see. You can go ahead and test these methods out for yourself and go ahead and comment in the section below. Let us know which eye dominant you are. Are you left eye dominant, right eye dominant, or maybe neither? Go ahead and comment in the section below. All right, everyone, thanks so much for watching. Hopefully you found this video helpful. Give me a big thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe if you're new to the channel. And if you'd like to see other cool videos from Dr. Eye Health, just click or tap the screen up here to the side, or go ahead and click or tap the screen down over here. Otherwise, again, this is Dr. Joe Allen here from Dr. Eye Health. The channel helps you with the eyes, vision, and finding the best vision products. Keep an eye on it. We'll talk to you soon.